Hey everybody, this is Michael Pavlovich, and welcome to Intro to ZBrush Part 2. This section contains almost 8 hours of instruction spread out over 70 videos. If you haven't already done it, go ahead and check out the Intro to ZBrush Part 1, which is free on my YouTube channel, Gumroad, and the Lumi 3D Studios website under Courses. Part 1 alone is 6 hours of instruction with almost 50 videos, and a great resource to get you up and running in ZBrush. And then once you're comfortable with part one basics, it's time to crank your ZBrush abilities up a notch. Part two is going to start with custom hotkeys, custom interfaces, and custom menus right up front. This is going to provide you with a speed boost as well as turn ZBrush into an extension of your brain. What I mean by that is instead of digging around in menus and submenus, you're going to develop your own workflow to make sure you're staying fluid and creating with what's on your screen and not off to the side digging through options and punching in numbers. After that, we continue where part one left off. In part one, we cover the basic sculpting brushes, and in part two, we'll continue that discussion by delving into the more complex brush options within ZBrush. We'll start off with the insert mesh brush functionality, subtool merge dynameshing, multi-mesh insert brushes, and finally, creative custom insert and multi-mesh insert brushes. We'll even discuss how you can modify a mesh from a pre-existing insert mesh brush, as well as capturing parts from an external source for use in your own insert mesh library. Next, we'll talk about base mesh creation techniques for your characters. So part one ended on some quick concept bust sculpting. In part two, we're going to go over a number of ways to create base meshes for an entire character or creature, or a base mesh for any object, really. So we'll cover dynamesh base mesh techniques, adding insert mesh body parts, Z-sphere, and Z-sketching for the ultimate in fluid ZBrush mesh creation. And finally, my favorite as a production artist, starting with a body you've already made in the past. Once you've got a whole body to play with, we'll discuss different ways to get it posed out, from transpose and masking to Z-superposing. And once you've got all your big changes kind of locked down in ZBrush, we'll go over Z-remesh functionality and different ways to utilize this feature along with subtool projection to get you a nice, clean, sculptable mesh to take that into the wrinkle and pore detail. And of course, you can also use Z-remesh for your gamer's mesh needs as well. Now, around this point is when we get into the real meat of part two and where the exciting stuff starts happening. From here on out, we're going to be mostly hitting all the different ways you can create accessory meshes in ZBrush to start adding complexity and functionality to your subject. We'll start by going over different ways to break apart and refine your concept sculpts. We'll use this method as we flesh out a sci-fi armor chest piece that might remind you of the armor seen for the cover art for the Intro to ZBrush Part 3, the video series after this one. We'll then use the extract method to create a shirt, add details to the shoulder pads, and finish it off with a Z-remesh and subdivision sculpt for the final look. We'll also go over a few best practices when it comes to adding cloth and sculpted cloth details. We'll touch on morph diff as a mesh creation technique, as well as mask and Z-remesh for a pair of pants. And at this point, we'll have a lot of subtools in our subtool menu, so we'll go over some basic and advanced subtool organization techniques. Once you're comfortable navigating through your subtools, we'll hop back into more accessory mesh creation. Starting with a topology brush, we'll create a helmet and some pads, and then we'll go over the various curve fill brushes and how they might be useful in adding complex shapes to your overall object. Then we'll cover Z-sphere topology for both retopologizing high-res source meshes to create a game-res mesh, as well as making addendums to your ever-increasing subtool menu. We'll also make sure to hit on shadowbox functionality, and finally wrap up part 2 with a deep dive into custom insert mesh and insert curve mesh functionality, including the mind-bending tri-curve mesh brush, and all the different ways you can utilize that to give you the illusion of complexity, when really what you're mostly doing is dragging, snapping, framing curves, and calling it a day. As an added bonus, there will be an overview video at the end on the creation of the H.P. Lovecraft Nameless City reptile seal creature you see as a cover art for this section. It'll cover the entire creation, from the body concept blockout all the way to the high-frequency detail bust sculpt, the polypainting process for that sculpt, and finally a step-through of the KeyShot render pass process and the compositing and done in Photoshop. So, by the end of part two, you'll be a base mesh, accessory mesh, concept and production artist machine. It doesn't end there, though. Part 3, we crank it up yet another notch, because believe it or not, there's a lot more cool stuff in ZBrush yet to cover. So enough introduction, let's get ZBrushing.